Hello, everyone. My name is Jesse Pham, and welcome to the Aviation Student Panel Session. In this session, we have Dr. Perez, Julia Bradley, and Sal Khan, who will be speaking to you during the session. And we will start off with some brief housekeeping items, followed by the Q&A session. So when you have a question, please use the Q&A button along the bottom to submit questions, and we will try to answer them in the order that they were posted. There's also a chat room for you to make comments or chat with your peers. And as a reminder, please always use appropriate language while chatting or commenting. This Q&A session is designed to help both students and parents learn more about our program. And with that, I will go ahead and give it to our presenters. Just a reminder, this session will be around 30 minutes, and we encourage you to explore other sessions that may be of your interest. And there are multiple programs and majors offering Q&A sessions today, so you can answer any sessions you want, and we encourage you to explore all we have to offer. All right, and there you go.
So it looks like someone has a question about the process of minoring in aviation. Do you want to answer that, Dr. Bruce?
In order to get a minor in aviation, you need to take a total of 4 courses, typically 2 lower division and 2 upper division courses. And in the aviation program, we offer 4 options. So depending on your option, whether or not it's going to be professional flight, management, maintenance, or operations, then we can advise you which 4 courses you need to take. It's a simple process, but you must pass the courses.
How does flight training work? Sal, you want to do that?
How does flight training work? So it depends which option you go to. So if you're doing aviation in professional flight, you will be doing your college classes and flight training together at the same time. Whereas if you're doing flight operations, you can do your flight training completely separate at your own pace. If you're doing professional flight, you have to be on a very steadfast pace, because you have to graduate with your commercial. So pretty much the way I look at it, as most students do, it's a double major.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot of work. So if you're going to pick that, you're going to want to be doing flying during the summer and on your breaks. So if you're someone who wants to go home in between semesters, it's probably not going to be the best option for you. But it is a great option. So if you're willing to do the work, it's worth it.
If you're going to be in the professional flight program, just remember there are 3 courses you are expected to take, and they are related to flying. You have to take some flying lessons, and we have a scheduled program so that you would be doing any of those, like private, instrument, and commercial in your freshman year, sophomore year, and your junior year. I'd like to remind you, the cost of the flight lessons are not covered by your tuition. We have 2 affiliate schools that you can attend and learn how to fly, but overall it's going to cost you close to $45,000 to $50,000 in addition to the tuition you pay for those combined 3 classes.
Mm-hmm. Someone asked what flight schools we're partnered with. We have 2 flight schools. One is Tradewinds Aviation and one is Squadron 2 Aviation, and those are both located at Reid Hillview Airport. So if you want to go check those out when they're open, I think Tradewinds is closed right now. And you can kind of interview some people and get a feel for which one you'd like to attend.
And these 2 flight schools are adjacent to our aviation facilities, including our hangar at Reid Hillview Airport, which is a county airport near East Ridge Mall in San Jose, California.
Mm-hmm. If someone has their private pilot license, what differences that make when they come in as a pro flight major?
If you're coming with a private license already, it means you have already completed Aviation 3 in our program. However, you still need to sign up for the course, but you don't have to take any learning lessons or flight lessons. So at the end of the semester, if you show us your certificate that you know how to fly and you have a private license, we will give you credit. The course is based on credit, no credit. If you complete the work, if you earn your license, you get a credit, but if you don't, you get a no credit. So if you come in, You just cannot say, yeah, he has it. You have to sign up for the course. At the end of the semester, we assign you credit that you have done this work, not at SGSU, but someplace else.
Mm-hmm. As an incoming undergraduate student, what airlines does SGSU partner up with in order for students to have jobs after they graduate? I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, we're not currently partnered with a specific airline. I know there's people who have been working on partnerships, but we do have a lot of alumni working for different airlines, and that networking opportunity creates a lot of job opportunities for people graduating through SGSU. So just by knowing a lot of people in the different airlines helps tremendously in getting jobs.
But you and Sal can talk about your employment opportunities, because our students work at San Jose International Airport, mm-hmm. Oakland International Airport, San Francisco, mm-hmm. with Hillview, San Martin. We have smaller airlines like Signature Air, Atlantis, that the students actually work at.
Yeah, and some are at SkyWest, I know, and Compass as well.
Right.
Yeah. And we very much encourage internships. So in lieu of taking one technical elective, you can take a 3-unit internship class that allows you to work for any of these companies.
Mm-hmm. Will I get the restricted ATP certificate when I come out of the program?
The answer is yes, because we just received our Part 141 certification last July. So yes, you will be graduating with the ATP.
Can we come in with our private and still get our instrument and commercial with one of the flight schools? Yes, you can. I think Dr. Brez answered that about coming in with your private earlier.
And you can also take instrument as well as commercial at the same time, because some students ask the question, do I have to take them in a series? Not necessarily. You can take them at the same time when you are a San Jose State. But you need to listen to what Julia said. It's probably more appropriate for you to do it during summertime, because you're not bound to go into class, take your flight lessons. If you could accommodate that during the summertime, do it, because it's not dependent on the fees that you pay at San Jose State University.
What's the difference between minoring in professional flight and flight operations? I don't think you can minor in professional flight, can you?
You can minor, because it's a matter of taking courses. You take courses, but in order to be able to become a pilot, you still need to have flight lessons.
Mm-hmm.
They cannot consider, our private course is called Aviation 3, our instrument is called Aviation 63, and our commercial is called 613. You cannot use any of these three classes towards a minor.
Sal, do you want to talk about cost and aid for flying?
Yeah, as Dr. Brez mentioned, that the tuition does not cover your flight training costs. So the two schools do differ in prices, not by much. It really depends on the aircraft. So for Tradewinds, they do have the newer aircraft. Squadron 2 does have a little older aircraft, but it's a little cheaper. Typically for a private pilot, I would recommend probably putting aside about $10,000 to $15,000 aside. And for instrument, probably about the same. And commercial, maybe about $20,000 to $25,000, because commercial is mostly time building. So you are paying, you know, more hours per flight.
It's going to end up being about $60,000 to $70,000.
Yeah.
Give or take. But there are a lot of financial aid opportunities. There's a ton of scholarships. I know Sal and I, we're big on scholarships. We both applied to many, and we've received a lot of help, and that is huge. And you can also work at the flight schools. They offer some discounts, not huge, but it does make a difference. And pretty much both flight schools hire San Jose State students to work there. So there's ways to minimize the costs of it.
I would like to make a comment that at San Jose State University, the tuition is the lowest probably in the United States of America in terms of a public school. We are the least expensive. That's number one. Yeah. Number two, in order to become a professional flight graduate as a pilot, the total cost for 4 years or 5 years is going to be less than 1 year at some of our competitor schools. That's what I can tell you. In addition to that, the department is very blessed to have had a lot of good donors. We have a number of scholarships from $10,000 per year to $7,000 per year, to $5,000 per $4,000, $3,000, $1,000. So we have a lot of money available, but you need to demonstrate that you are a good student scholastically, you are active in the organization. For example, both Julia as well as Sal, they are very helpful, cooperative in helping our students during the open houses and any other events that I have. And so yeah, as long as you're participating, helping the department, you're entitled to apply for good scholarships.
Mm-hmm. Someone asked, will I receive my CFI or CFII? That is not included in our program. You come out with your commercial certificate, and then what most people do is they'll continue with their CFI or II at one of our flight schools. I know some of the flight schools offer some kind of scholarship if you're willing to work for them for a certain period of time to help you get your CFI after you graduate. So there's options for that, but it's not included in the program. How can the program help me get my private pilot license? Sal, you wanna?
Yeah, definitely. So Aviation 2, again, is a ground class for the private. The instructor pretty much prepares you for the knowledge test. It's not going to help you so much with the flight training. You do cover the aerodynamics and stuff like that of it. But for the knowledge test, you will definitely pass the first try if you take the class. Also working with other students who are doing flight training helps you, you know, get through your private much faster. If you want to add anything, Julia.
Nope, that's good. What is the time commitment like? The time commitment is insane. Yeah. You have to be willing to put in the work. A lot of people have, that's the biggest drawback, is they think it's going to be a lot less work than it is, and then they find out later they can't do it. So you have to go in knowing that you need to set aside the time to do flight training, especially if you're taking a full load of classes. A lot of people work. It's very difficult to manage your time. So you have to be on top of it. And the summers are the biggest thing. If you want to get through it, you need to make use of the time that you have not in school. So know
Sal,
that.
Sal, did you want to comment?
Yeah, I mean, pretty much what Julia said. And you have to be willing to give up your free days. Particularly for private, you definitely want to fly at least 4 to 5 times a week because you are learning the basics.
Work could do it.
I mean, yeah, depending on your work schedule or school load, yeah. You know, but mm-hmm. You know, learning the basics of flying, you have to put in the time.
Hard part, yeah.
The comment I'd like to make would be, typically a student is called a full-time student if they are carrying 15 units. Therefore, you can just imagine if you are taking 15 units, you are a full-time student. You really don't have time to do anything else. I know many of our students, just like Sal, as well as Julia, they are very dedicated. They set aside time to work and be able to go to school. So mm-hmm. The comment that Julia made is very good. Spend your summer times, work, and take your flight lessons at that time. Save your money so that during the academic year, you can take 15 or even more units to complete your degree in hopefully in 4 years. Mm-hmm. In general, most of our students, they graduate in about 5 to 5.5 years. And the reason is because they are working, they are unable to take a 15 unit load each semester.
Yeah. How many flight simulators does the university have? What type? Sal is, he's in charge of that, so I'm gonna let him talk about that.
So we do have one full motion AATD, and we also have about 10 to 11 TD2s, and we have 2 Frascas. We use that for the instrument ground class. And the Frascas are mostly used for the flight team that we have.
And the flight simulators are made by Red Bird. I'm not sure if they understand the manufacturer.
Yeah, Red Bird.
Would this be the place for those who want to be in aviation administration instead of becoming a pilot? Yes. We have a lot of aviation management and operations majors that go into the administration side. Our classes kind of handle the full breadth of the industry. So you're going to get management classes, human factors classes, systems classes, business aviation classes, and kind of everything. So it's a very well-rounded degree, and it's a good jumping off point for anyone who wants to go into any part of the industry.
Airline management, airport management, these are some of the other courses. I'd like to make a comment in here. The students that we have in our aviation program, I'm very proud of them, and they have the tightest bond. For example, in particular, the Precision Flight Team, they organize events every Friday night during the academic year from 5 to about 8 p.m., and the flight simulation lab is right across my office. So I can see these guys are coming in, and juniors and seniors teach freshmen and sophomores how to fly on the simulators. And this is at their own time. Nobody is getting paid in here. They do it so that they could help the younger generation of pilots that are going to be at San Jose State University. So my hats off to both Sal as well as Julia for being a couple of those students that they spent Friday night at San Jose State University.
Yeah, and there's not a lot of questions in here on that, but the Precision Flight Team, I joined my senior year, and I wish I had joined 2 years earlier. It's the best experience you will ever have if you join. You can make long-lasting friendships. You get more flight experience, different flight experience than you would just taking your lessons. And I think I've learned more with the team than I even did just in my training in different aspects. So if you're going to be a professional flight major, you should definitely join the flight team. It's worth it.
Sal, do you have any comments? You are the captain.
And I think Julia covered most of it. It will definitely help you progress and excel in your flight training, like you mentioned. If there's something that you don't understand that your instructor is trying to teach you, most likely someone from flight team will be able to approach you at a different angle that will help you much more. So joining the flight team is definitely worth it.
Yeah.
The other comment I'd like to make would be, if you're a member of the Precision Flight Team, you have the opportunity to travel across the country and compete on behalf of San Jose State University. And you would be our ambassador of our aviation program at many of these events that you can promote our aviation at San Jose State University. For your information, San Jose State University aviation program is number one in California and the West Coast. And it's rated number four across the country. And it's a terrific recognition that we have earned over the past several years.
Yeah, and we were headed to nationals this spring in Oshkosh, but unfortunately because of coronavirus, it got canceled. So we're all very sad about that.
The whole event is canceled, not just us.
That's a bummer. Will it be possible to play a varsity sport and major in pro flight? I would highly advise against that. If you're going to do flight training and take a full load of classes and do a varsity sport, that's a lot to juggle. You'd have to be extremely diligent in time management. And even then, I don't think it would make sense. I would probably do flight operations if you were going to play a varsity sport. I wish I could say something different, but I just think that's, I don't know.
So
that's a lot.
Julia, the comment we need to make would be, if you like to become a pilot for a commercial airline, then yes, it's worthwhile to go through a professional flight. But if you just want to learn to become a pilot, you can just do the first one, which is private. You graduate, you start your own company, and then you can have your own airplane. You can fly from location to location. So there's a difference. Don't assume that if you want to be a pilot for fun, you don't have to be in professional flight. You can just take only the private and be a pilot.
Yeah, we have a lot of students who do that, who just get their private, and then they major in operations or management or something else, and they fly on the side because they want to. That's very common. Is there multi-engine aircraft training in SJS used flight school? Yes, I think there is, right, Sal?
We do not have it at this time. We do have it at Tradewinds. They do have it. Multi-engine. We do not have it at San Jose State in our curriculum, but I'm working on it.
Yeah, but there is an option for that if you want to get that at one of the flight schools. We have those.
Correct.
Will I be able to do ROTC? Yeah, we have a lot of students actually who do ROTC. A lot.
And their office is right in our building.
It's right by our club room. It's right above all our classrooms. So it's very, you can talk to one of them and I'm sure they can give you the correct information on that.
That's a very cost-effective way to get flight lessons and flight training without much of a cost.
Okay, yeah, I don't know too much about that, but I'm sure, yeah. Do we have an altitude chamber? We do not.
I wish we did.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Do I need to attend the private pilot classes if I already have my private pilot certificate.
I said that before.
They can't test out of that one?
Usually it's not a test. If they already have a private pilot license in their hand, they can sign up for Aviation 3. At the end of the semester, just flash that card and then they get credit.
Okay, yeah, so you get credit for it. As an upcoming transfer student, what are the necessary steps if I want to begin working at a minor in aviation for the fall 2020? There's a minor form, I think, online, and it tells you what classes to take. I think it's like four or five classes.
Four classes, but I need to tell them which four classes depending on their option.
Okay. So you'd want to talk to Dr. Baraz and he can...
And I don't recommend doing this during your first semester. Focus on your major when you come in, and then slowly, maybe by your end of your sophomore year or junior year, start considering taking courses for the minor.
Yeah.
Remember, you're coming to San Jose State University for a major. We are hoping that maybe even you consider aviation program as your major. But if it's going to be a minor, I would say focus on your major first before you consider minor.
Mm-hmm. Someone asked again about aviation administration. We answered that earlier, but a lot of people are in that field. The management and operations major both kind of set you towards that direction. The classes are good for that. If I come in with my private pilot license, will I not be earning my instrument rating until my second year? No, you can start that if you already have your certificate. I think you can start that right away.
They can start anytime. As I said, they can take instrument and commercial at the same time, but it's the time and time and money that's going to prevent you from doing it. So be careful.
Yeah.
How should I join flight team? You could talk to Sal. He is the current president, or he can give you the phone number for the president next year. I don't know if we're allowed to put our phone numbers in the chat or anything, but you're more than welcome to reach out to anybody, and they'd be happy to help you answer questions about clubs and flight team and all that stuff.
They can send an email to the department, and then our department admin will forward it to me. Then I will share it with Julia as well as Sal.
How long does it take to get your instrument, Sal?
Well, it depends if you're doing professional flight or ops. If you're doing ops, then it's pretty much could take you up to a year because you're taking your time. If you're doing professional flight, I would say it should take you about maybe 8 months. Depends how much time you're putting into studying.
Yeah. So mine was about a year. I'm in the process of getting my check ride and now it's put off, but it's about a year. I think Sal was, you were about the same.
Yeah, mine was about 9 months, and then waiting on a check ride also takes.
Yeah. If you fly for the Air Force, if I want to fly for the Air Force, what would I need? I would talk to ROTC. We have a lot of people in the reserves that are students as well in our program. So you could reach out to a recruiter. I would talk to the ROTC people and they can set you in the right direction, especially if you're right out of high school.
And we also have some professors that are part-time instructors. They have gone through that scenario. So they could also talk to some of the professors who have gone through that experience of ROTC going to the military to gain their experience of being a commercial pilot.
What does one choose to take, pro flight option? I'm confused by that question.
It's the love and passion. It's the love and passion. Do you want to be a pilot? Do you envision yourself to be flying a Boeing 777 or a Airbus 380, and then you say, that's what I like to do for life. Therefore, you have a passion to become a pilot. Therefore, you go through their professional flight program.
Yeah, if you're asking about classes, if you go to the flight page on SJSU, there's the different major options, and you can click them, and it tells you what classes you're going to be taking.
It's called the roadmap.
The roadmap, yeah. So that's a good place to go for that. Is the aviation department at SJSU one of the most prestigious programs in the nation? Yes.
Yes, it is.
Number four, I think, right?
We are number four. In addition to that, when you talk to some of the pilots, you ask them, where did you get your education? It's San Jose State. Mm-hmm. Our program is 86 years old. It's one of the oldest programs on campus. And it used to be a training grounds for training pilots for World War II.
Do I need an FAA medical exam for aviation, yes. And I recommend getting a first class, especially if you're going on to be a professional pilot, so you know that you pass the first class before you do all the training and all the money. If you're just getting your private, you only need a third class. Yeah, that's it. Hands-on training. Yeah,
lots of hands-on training.
Yeah, especially like simulators, 62.
Yeah. You get to build engines, you get to work on planes, which is so cool. We learned how to change tires, rig ailerons. You get tons of really cool, interesting stuff that's very useful.
If you are taking courses at our facilities by the airport, you have the option to walk into some of the other schools that they do maintenance. You can just talk to the staff and just learn from everybody who's at the airport at Reed Hillview. That's mm-hmm. where the community is all about. They can actually communicate the same language and they can learn from each other. Maybe you're going to be a pilot, but you can walk into an area, you see the guys are working on the engine, you can ask questions, you have a better understanding. That's one of the best classrooms that we have.
Mm-hmm. Is there transportation between the main campus and the two flight schools? Yes. I know there's a bus system. There may be a Caltrain system.
No, it's the only bus with the VTA.
Okay.
But if you're going to be driving there, the Reed Hillview Airport is about 6 miles away from school. Uh-huh. So it may take about 45 minutes with bus, but if you drive, it's going to be less than 15 minutes.
Yes. And there's a lot of students going to the classes from school, and you'll get to know them. And a lot of people carpool if you don't have a car. There's definitely ways to get you over there. So
One of the things we do is we try to schedule most of our junior or senior classes back to back in that facility. So you don't have to, on a daily basis, you don't have to go back and forth between the main campus and Reed Hillview Airport. That's what we try to accommodate so we minimize your commute.
Mm-hmm. What laptop would you recommend for an aviation major? Any that works?
Yeah.
Just one you can afford and one that works. I think that's all. If you have your instrument rating, will you get credit for it? I don't know, Dr. Burke.
Yes, of course. If you have any of those ratings, if you have a license in your hand, you bring it to me or bring it to the instructor of those courses. If you already have had it, you say sign up for the course, then we will accept that credit. We cannot just automatically give you the credit. You have to enroll in the class. It's different from if you have taken a math course at a community college, you come in and you say, I've taken the math, and here's my transcript, because you cannot bring a transcript from a flight school to us because they are considered different from an academic environment.
Are freshmen allowed parking passes on campus? I have no idea.
Yeah, they can park on campus, but they have to pay for the parking permit.
Yeah.
And the beauty at the Reed Hillview Airport is there's no parking fees. There's ample parking space you can park there when you go to take your classes.
We have 1 minute left, so yes, we might need all this.
Julie, in 15 seconds, tell them what you know, and then Sal, another 15 seconds.
Go ahead, Julia.
No, I'm not going to read any more questions because we don't have time, but if you have any other questions, you can
send it to me. Email it to me.
And yeah. Dr. Barrett. Talk to you personally about more. But thank you guys. I hope you join.
Sally, any last minute comment?
If any of you guys have questions or want to hear personal, experiences, anything about the flight team, the other clubs, please reach out to Dr. Brez. He can give you my number. Please reach out to me. We'll give you guys the full story of how it is, how it works. Don't be shy to give us a call or shoot us an email.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Thank you so much for your interest in our aviation program at San Jose State University. These are great guys and they would be very happy to help you. And we look forward to seeing you on campus in the fall, not online, but in person.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Julia. Sal.
Thank you, Dr. Rez.
You're welcome. Okay,
so that's all for the aviation student panel. I'd like to thank our panelists for their time, and we will now be transitioning to the technology student panel. Thank you again, Dr. Perez, Sal, and Julia for your time. I will now be inviting Yvette Vaca and Bradley Young to the panel as we begin the technology student panel session. All right, and with that, please go ahead and take it away.
Good morning, Good morning, Yvette. Good morning, Bradley. Thanks so much for helping me on this program.
Good morning.
Go ahead. You guys want to say something about the program? And then answer a question. Yvette, maybe you can answer the questions on chat that is coming in.
Oh, sure.
Go ahead and introduce yourself. Tell us which level you are in, which concentration.
Okay. So I'm Yvette. I'm in my fourth year in SJSU, and I am in industrial technology, and my focus is in manufacturing.
Bradley?
Hi there. Can you guys hear me?
We can hear you.
Okay. So my name is Bradley Young, and I'm a graduating senior in the CNSM program. And then to answer the question that just came in, there's all kinds of companies that are available for CNSM majors. It really depends on what you want to do, because CNSM is pretty diverse in terms of networking technology or cloud security, blockchain, or some other stuff. Really, the choice is up to you.
Well, you want to mention the partnership we have with Cisco and Cisco's affiliate company called Meraki. So we have a sponsorship from Cisco. There are four courses, introductory courses in our program, from IoT to IoT systems, network administration, network systems. If you take these four courses during your first 2 years, by the summer after your junior, after your sophomore year, you are interviewed by Cisco for an internship, and you are hired by them. You can work there, make good money, and take courses such as internship. By doing the work at Cisco, you can also earn credit. So as Bradley said, there are a number of companies that we work with. We place our students not only on campus opportunities, but also off-campus opportunities.
Another question, when did the computer network system management major introduce SJSU? How is the student / industry response? I think the CNSM was just created about a year ago, right?
It started 2 years ago, but the admission started in fall 2019, last semester. It is new, but it is replacing another concentration we had before. And this particular program is very popular among a number of community colleges, because especially community colleges were training people or providing education in this field, but there were no university that they would accept those courses towards a bachelor's degree. Now we have created an opportunity for all these community colleges, as well as new students that come to San Jose State University, to be able to take courses towards a bachelor's degree in technology, industrial technology, with lucrative job employment, as well as doing something productive in the society, in particular in the area of cybersecurity.
How about the job opportunities for manufacturing focus? So for manufacturing, it's a lot about design and solving problems. So it's more hands-on, definitely. You could still get jobs at Cisco, basically any kind of manufacturing. There's Jabil.
Tesla,
yeah. So any kind of big, even small operations, like they need us to help them solve problems. And we'll have like SolidWorks and CAD backgrounds. So let's see, who will be facilities for IoT cybersecurity? Will the faculties be from CMPE department for specific courses?
No. We have our own courses, very different from computer engineering. As a matter of fact, we are more advanced in those areas than even our computer engineering. We are the school or the department that introduced the IoT course. We are the first department who has offered a course on blockchain. We are the first department who has a course on industrial IoT. So we are way advanced compared to computer engineering or software engineering. And the beauty of our program is very hands-on. You need to make devices, connect them to the internet, and monitor performance. So Bradley can probably talk about that because he took 67 and some of the other classes at San Jose State University. Bradley?
Hello?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, I was saying my mic wasn't working for a second. Anyways, we have our own professors, and they like to do lots of hands-on projects, and it really helps you learn, because when you have to troubleshoot it yourself, you really figure out everything that has to go right to make the project work.
The beauty in here is that we have our own full-time professors, but we are blessed to be in Silicon Valley and have so many part-time instructors that come from industry. These are the people that are doing work in these areas, like cybersecurity, on a daily basis. That's their job. And they are willing to come and teach courses for us at San Jose State University to prepare you for opportunities, cybersecurity, Internet of Things, blockchain, machine learning. These are all the stuff that they teach you.
Are the classes hard to get for CNSM?
The answer is no. If there's demand, I open up new sections. That's what we have done. We even this semester, before we were forced to go online, we have classes that we were offering on Saturdays, because the classroom and the labs were very occupied during the week. We had no other choice but to open up new sections, and we open them on Saturday. My goal is to have small classes, not more than 30 to 45 students for better education. And when we have multiple sections, then typically the limit is about 30 students per class. So there's no problem getting into classes. If somebody comes and says, I would like to take that class, I cannot take it, I would either talk to the instructor or I will open up a new section.
And I can vouch for that. It's really easy to get classes in CNSM.
Another question that came up is whether I can take the minor computer science with major CNSM if I obtain good GPA?
It all depends on the other department. We don't control minor, but I can tell you this, the students in our program, in the industrial technology program, you are very fortunate, because by the time you finish your bachelor's degree in technology, you also have earned a minor in business, because there are 5 courses that are embedded in our program that you need to take in order to earn a minor in business. So if you like to get a minor in computer science or computer engineering or software engineering, you need to talk to those departments, not us. We don't control minor outside of our department.
Another question. I am a transfer student coming in the fall. If I've taken computer networking classes before at a community college, but it's been a while since I've taken them, is it possible for me to audit the computer networking courses in the CNSM major?
Absolutely. You let me know that you would like to do that. I will ask the instructor to take you without giving you any specific assignment or requiring you to enroll in class. Yes, we would be happy to do that.
Hi, I want to make education plan after transfer. There, my major is industrial technology and networking. Can I do that for now or after transfer there?
You can do this right now. If you go to our website, there are what we call roadmaps. It's the list of courses you need to take in 4 years at San Jose State University, depending on your option. So you can look at that particular list of courses, and you can check off the ones you think you already have completed at a community college. Then you know what's left that you have to complete. And if you are not sure about some of those courses, there is always a couple of websites, assist.org, www.assist.org, or www.articulation.org. You can go to this website and it tells you, for example, our Tech 65 introduction to networking is equivalent to which particular course at which particular university. So you can actually lay out your plan by looking at the roadmap and crossing out what was taken, what is left. It's that easy. No more questions?
Yeah, there's no. Oh, you just got one. Could you please let us know the respected faculty/professors going to teach my major CNSM?
It depends. So if you're going to be taking courses in this CSM, it's going to be Dr. Ostovari. is going to be Dr. Mazabin. It's going to be a number of professors, Richard Grotegat, YL Abdul-Jabbar, Balaji. So we have a number of part-time faculty as well as full-time faculty members that are going to be teaching these classes.
All right. Just while we're waiting for questions, I could talk about my experiences in manufacturing.
Yes, do that, please.
So I've transferred into IS manufacturing in about a year or two ago, and I've really enjoyed it. What I think is different about CNSM is that it's has more hands-on training, and you get to work with different manufacturing tools. You get to work in workshops and kind of get a more hands-on experience in your classes. So it's not just a lecture. We have another question. Why was there no PowerPoint for this site for the major industrial technology?
There was. It was provided to the college. I'm not so sure what happened, but yeah, I gave them one already.
Another thing about manufacturing or industrial technology in general is that it's very well-rounded. It's not really one direction. You get to learn a little bit of everything. There are some programming classes. There's you get to learn how to use SolidWorks and CAD programs, as well as learning how to use lathes and tools and safety workshop safety. That's part of the reason why I wanted to join industrial technology over other engineering majors.
Do you want to talk about your experience working on the project, independent project that you're working on right now with the Toyota? It's okay, we can mention the name Toyota as a project.
Okay. So I'm working with Dr. Rose and a group of other students we're working on a project for Toyota, and it's we're creating an interior for specifically for disabled people. And so we got a group of people, occupational therapy, industrial design, human factors, and a couple other engineers. And we've been working as a group. We started with an ideation process and everything that we wanted to implement in this vehicle and how it's gonna benefit our passengers. And we've gone through multiple stages, and we created a 3D print model and sent that out to the company and our executives, as well as created a full-scale model project. And we're still in this stage right now. And it's been a really rewarding experience, and I've learned a lot from it. So we have another question. Do students that finish majoring in CNSM find jobs easily after they graduate?
Bradley, do you want to comment or should I say something? Go ahead, Bradley, first.
All right, so CNSM is a new major, so we'll find out. But so far, it's looking pretty good. Got scouted by a couple companies, had a couple interviews. So I think it's going pretty well so far. The predecessor major, where it was sent before CNSM, my friends have had a great time finding jobs.
To my knowledge, there is no problem. As a matter of fact, Cisco and a couple of other companies, they periodically during the spring semester, except this semester, it's going to be tough. They come and make a pitch and they try to recruit the students. So they have been very successful at taking our students as interns as well as for full-time employment.
I guess we have a last minute warning. So for this last question, the student faculty ratio for computer network system management.
The ratio, I think it's about maybe 10 to 1.
All right.
So our current enrollment in technology is about 465 students, And I think it's about 300 that are in the computer network and balance are in manufacturing. I'd like to make a couple of comments in here. As Yvette mentioned, our program is very hands-on. We are trying to create applied engineers. We educate you to become an applied engineer. The beauty, as I mentioned earlier, was not only you earn a major, but you will also earn a minor. The other special thing that we have in our program is the fact that you can take courses and internship. If you have employment opportunity at one of the companies, you can sign up for internship. If you are an intern at the company, you can work there, get experience, and use that experience towards 3 units of credit towards your degree. Furthermore, we also have what we call independent study or research. So you can work with one of the professors on a specific project and do research, either build something or do research and write a paper, go to a conference and make a presentation. This is very unique to our program that we encourage undergraduate research activities.
All right, so I guess we reached our time limit, but I'm very open. If you want to message the department and through Dr. Perez, I'm willing to share my email and my phone number answer any more questions that you guys have or if you need any help.
Yeah, please send me your questions. I would be happy to forward it to either Yvette or Bradley.
Okay, so that looks like that's all the time we have. Thank you for all your excellent questions. If you have any further questions, please email them to engineering@sjsu.edu. At this time, I would like to invite you to exit the meeting and visit other sessions that may be of interest to you. So thank you so much, Dr. Perez, Yvette, and Bradley. And I would like to thank all of the attendees for their time and congratulations on being accepted as a Spartan. We look forward to seeing you in the fall. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Yvette. Thank you, Bradley.
Thank you.
Bye.